Hello everyone and welcome back to Children's Church Online. My name is Jenny Blake and I am the Children's Pastor here at Bryanston Methodist Church. I'm so happy you guys have tuned in today and I hope you learned something brand new. If you're new here, hello and welcome. If you're not new here, hello and welcome. And when am I seeing you back at Children's Church? There's only two more Sundays left. And our last Sunday, we're going to have a party. So make sure you come and bring a friend because it's going to be so much fun. All right. So, how do we normally start Children's Church? Is it with a prayer or is it with birthdays? We should probably start with a prayer, right? Because it's always about God. Okay. Hands together. Close your eyes and bow your heads. You can say it after me or in your own language. Let's go. We're saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Cool. So, if it was your birthday this past week, or today, happy, happy birthday. I hope you had a fantastic day. And since birthdays are so special, we should celebrate them with our friends, right? So that means we need to sing happy birthday to our special people in our lives. So your voices are nice and warm from the birthday song? Good, because now we're doing a worship song.
Born is the King.
Now, we need to have warm bodies because that's good for your health. So we should get up and dance. So let's dance!
Get ready to get down, get funky, and get loose, because we're having a dance party right here, right now. Hot diggity, let's boogie.
Everybody clap your hands, we gon' have a party. Turn around, do my dance, we gon' have a party. Two steps to the left,
one, two.
Two steps to the right,
one, two.
Let me see you get it low.
Low, low.
Now bring it back up,
one more time.
Two steps to the left,
one, two.
Two steps to the right,
one, two.
Let me see you get it low.
Low, low.
Freeze. Now shuffle, 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 shuffle. Now shuffle, 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 shuffle. Now shuffle, 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 shuffle. Freeze. Hey, too hot to cool down. 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 To the left,
one, two.
Two steps to the right,
one, two.
Let me see you get it low.
Low, low.
Now bring it back up,
one more time.
Two steps to the left,
one, two.
Two steps to the right,
one, two.
Let me see you get it low.
Low, low.
Freeze.
So now that we're nice and warm and have danced and sung, we should get into the lesson today. So today's reading comes from Luke chapter 21 verses 25 to 36. And it reads like this. There will be signs in the sun, moon, and stars. On the earth, nations will be in anguish and perplexity at the roaring and tossing of the sea. Men will faint in terror, apprehensive of what is coming on the world. For the heavenly bodies will be shaken. At that time, they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. When these things begin to take place, stand up and lift up your head, because your redemption is drawing near. He, Jesus, told them this parable. Look at the fig tree and all the trees. When they sprout leaves, you can see for yourself and know that summer is near. Even so, when you see these things happen, you know that the kingdom of God is near. I tell you the truth, this generation will certainly not pass away until all these things have happened. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. Be careful, or your hearts will be weighed down with disposition, drunkenness, and anxieties of life. And that day will come on you unexpectedly, like a trap. For it will come upon all those who live on the face of the whole earth. Be always on the watch and pray that you may be able to escape all that is about to happen, and that you may be able to stand before the Son of Man. So that was quite a long reading, but let's carry on with the lesson. To get started today, I have a question for you. Let's say somebody wants to help you with something, but that's something you're not very interested in. For example, I was thinking we could talk about learner's licenses. If you want, I can help you with your K53 learning. But, and this is important, do you have a K53 book? Do you know what K53 is? Not very well, right? However, someday, when you're a little bit older, you might need to learn K53. And then you might want my advice. Right? And this is how it goes with a lot of things in life. For some of us, we really can't learn anything about something until we need to think about it. Even if others are ready to teach us before we know it, we need it. So let me say that again. We really can't learn something until we think we need it. Even if others are ready to teach us about it before we need it. So in today's story, Jesus is talking to his disciples that the same thing is true for why some people might choose to pay attention to God. People might not learn about or want to pay attention to God until they experience something like pain or injustice, violence, and lots of other not so nice things. Then Jesus says, when these scary things happen, especially in a very big way, like wars and disasters, that's when people start saying, you know what? The way we do this isn't working. We need to do it a different way, and we need help figuring out this different way. It is during these scary times, then that's Jesus is saying, the world is more likely to listen to God about God's better way. And Jesus promises that his words that teach us about God's better way will always be there for us to listen to. But here's the thing. We don't have to wait until things are really bad before we can start listening to the words of God. We can start right now. Today would be a great day to start or to continue doing so, because today is the first Sunday in Advent. And now you guys know I'm excited about Advent. So let me tell you what Advent is. Advent is a time of year, normally starts 4 Sundays before Christmas, in which we prepare to receive Jesus and his teachings about God's better way. So we light candles to remind us every Sunday before Christmas, the first 4 Sundays before Christmas, and each candle has a meaning, and today's candle would be purple. So this time of Advent is a time of waiting and preparing our hearts for God in all things, in all moments, at all places, and at all times. So Advent is far more than opening Christmas presents and Christmas trees and sending letters to Santa. Yes, those things are so much fun, but Advent and Christmas mean so much more. And we need to remember that and to respect that. And we should choose to listen and act on Jesus' words about God's better way now. Then we'll be better prepared to share the same words about God's better way to the world that is more and more ready to listen. That's the good news for today. Let's pray. This is a repeat after me prayer. So let's say it together. Oh, wait, before we start, hands together, eyes closed. Are they closed? Good. Repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for Jesus, who shows us how to live. Your better way, and then share it with those around us. Thank you, and Amen. And that is our lesson for today, everyone. I hope you guys are excited about Advent, and I hope that you will prepare your hearts for Jesus. Let's say the benediction together to close off our lesson. And we say together, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forever. Amen. I love you lots and lots. See you soon. Bye.